Hey there. Sorry, I was just confirming that these products contain microbeads. Turns out face scrubs like this one and toothpaste like this get their scrubbing powers from tiny bits of plastic. Yep, plastic. Why am I a little nervous about that? And how can you figure out whether they're in your toiletries? The answer, coming up. Hey everyone, Lauren here. There's been a lot of hubbub as of late surrounding microbeads. Companies have been putting these polyethylene spheres into personal care products for a while now. The problem is, once you've scrubbed your face or teeth with them, they go right down the drain. And wastewater treatment plants aren't designed to filter out the tiny balls, which are less than a millimeter in diameter. So the plastic bits are making their way into rivers and lakes. We know this partially thanks to Sherry Mason, an environmental chemist at the State University of New York in Fredonia. In 2011, Mason was sailing the waters of Lake Erie for a class trip when she got to thinking about plastics in the ocean. Mason wondered whether there were plastic debris in the freshwater Great Lakes, too. So the next year, she and a team went out looking. Turns out, 80% of the pieces of plastic they pulled from the water were these tiny particles. After some detective work, Mason and colleagues connected the perfectly spherical colored beads they found to products like these. Why might that be a cause for concern? Well, scientists have evidence that pollutants, such as polychlorinated biphenyls, concentrate on the surface of these beads. And these beads are getting eaten by fish. Not only that, but earlier this year, a dental hygienist named Trish Walraven blogged about how she's been seeing microbeads stuck in people's gums. No one knows exactly how bad these beads might be for people's gums or for animals in the food chain, but some folks are beginning to take action. For example, Procter & Gamble, which makes Crest toothpaste, vowed to phase microbeads out of its products entirely by March 2016. The state of Illinois has outlawed the tiny bits, although its ban doesn't take effect completely until 2019. In the meantime, if you decide you don't want microbeads in your gums or running down your drain, you can review your toiletries. Just look for polyethylene in the ingredients list. That's all the time we have for Speaking of Chemistry. Find out more at speakingofchemistry.org. Speak your mind below, and don't forget to subscribe and share.